20-inch double barrel 12 gauge coke gun with the hammers on it. They've got hammer locks. It doesn't allow the hammer to go forward unless the trigger is actually pulled. I got the trigger down. Now the trigger is not down. Same way. It's the only hammer shotgun I've been able to find. The fit and finish is nice of it. It's manufactured in Zhangzhou Machine Works in China, and imported by Century. A thick but fast. This is kind of going to be a dual review. We also have in it the short lane 12 gauge to 45 shotgun adapter. It is rifled and it's pretty accurate. First, I'm going to put just a lead cast bullet through it, 250 grains that I cast myself. Not much recoil. Can also have it loaded with a 45 Colt and a preferred shotgun load. I'm gonna load it with buckshot and gonna put another Hornady XTP 45 Colt in it, 255 grains. Buckshot first. 45 for this buck cut second. 12 gauge ejects fine. The 45 has a cutout groove in it that allows you to eject them out. Here I have another 45 Colt. I'm gonna put through the short lane adapter in my 20-inch coke gun, and I'm going to be shooting at a 12-inch round steel plate at 25 yards. I just want to kind of give you an idea of how accurate these guns with these adapters in them can be. Missed that one. Keep in mind these are no sights, just using the front B sight on the shotgun. Try again. Hit that time. Put another one through it. Get the idea. Okay, can't hit it. So we pounded this one. I'm gonna move over here to my 6-inch plate at 25 yards also. I'm only going to take one shot at this 6-inch plate. I'm just going to give you a general idea of as you can see, I hit it. 6-inch plate at 25 yards with nothing but the bead side of the shotgun and the short lane 45 Colt to 12 gauge adapter. It is a bug out adapter. I believe it's 5 inches in total length. Maybe 4 inches of actual rifling. But the accuracy of these adapters has surprised me. And you can actually index it to where it'll hit the point of impact will be where you desire it to be. You just simply take if it's hitting, say, to the right, you just take the adapter out, spin it to the left, push it back in. You index it with the extractor groove pretty much. And you can index the point of aim to point of impact to match up, so it wouldn't be that hard to actually get it to fire correctly. And I imagine with the use of a red dot sight or another sight, it would be even easier to get to work. get it zeroed in pretty much. Enough of the adapter, I'm gonna fire some buckshot for you. Okay, I'm gonna put a few rounds of buckshot on my silhouette target out there, just to give you guys a small overview of the recoil and the pattern this 20-inch barrel leaves. I'm gonna step on the other side of the camera so you can kind of see down the gun. I'm gonna cock both hammers. As you can see, I also loaded this buckshot myself, so it does have a little reduced recoil compared to factory loaded ammunition. Fire a few more rounds, then I'm gonna have to cut this video short because it's raining pretty good now. Alright, thank you guys for viewing. This is my review of the 20-inch Colt gun imported by Century, made by Zheng Zhao Machine Works in China. It's been an overall great shotgun. It looks and feels just like the Old West. And one of the extra selling points was the fact that it does have working hammers. I do believe I searched around and I could not find a double barrel coach that actually had working hammers, and that was one of the selling points to me. Thank you guys. I'm going to continue the review of the Century Arms double barrel 12 gauge coach gun on the inside, since it was raining pretty good on me on the range. It has the double hammers, as I was explaining on the range. It also has double triggers. You can fire each barrel individually, or you can pull both triggers and fire them simultaneously. It takes up to a 3-inch shell, so it takes just about all your buckshot and most of the game loads, and a lot of the slugs are also 3-inch and under. It has a very nice recoil pad on it. The recoil really isn't that bad because it's actually a beefy, pretty heavy gun. I also have a short lane 12 gauge to 45 Colt adapter, which is absolutely perfect. I love it. Like I stated on the video earlier, it is the bug out edition. It's actually rifled. I don't know how well you can see that. And it's fairly accurate. Like I was stating on the video, you can index the barrel to switch the point of aim and to the point of impact. It's fairly easy to use with just the bead sight on a shotgun. They make a 12-inch version that would possibly be even more accurate, but for practical plinking and stuff, this is, you know, I couldn't ask for more. I wouldn't be afraid to actually take this hunting with me to shoot at an animal at close range with. You know, 45 Colt really isn't that much of a powerhouse round, but it would definitely take a small game to medium game. Let me take the camera off the tripod here and I'll give you guys a close-up of the coach gun. The finish of the wood is actually very nice. It has a good checkering pattern on it. The shotgun itself is actually made in China, so it's a import, as with most Century Arm guns. I had a little trouble with the extractor in the beginning with factory birdshot loads, but just issues with it wanting to break open and extract, which I was using, you know, some bulk birdshot that was steel cased, well, not really steel cased, but steel based, and maybe that played some role in the extraction issues, but Other than that, it's been a real great gun. It's been very reliable. I've shot it quite a few thousand times now with buckshot and birdshot. And like I said, it's just a flawless gun. I wanted to showcase my sling I also have here. I actually ordered this off eBay. It come from a Amish leather maker. I thought that was a pretty cool add-on. It helps with the authenticity of the whole gun, the look of it. So, like I said, the biggest selling point was these right here, these double hammers that's rarely found on most coach guns of today. It come with the sling swivels already installed. Let you guys kind of get a sight picture of it. It has, of course, the safety on top, which is always a good thing. It has the lever release brake open. It is a cylinder bore, so it can shoot slugs and just about anything else. The pattern on it, depending on the load, is really not bad compared to most 20 inchers, but some people would classify them as scatter guns, but for plinking purposes and cowboy action shooting, I think it's a perfect gun.